Thank you.
Good afternoon, all, especially Dr. Philip Kotler, Hammond, and all founders of marketing and members here. I'm Thomas. It is a representative of Marketing Association of Cambodia. Now, we would like to brief you about a little bit about the Cambodia and cases of crisis COVID-19 situation. As you may know, our Cambodia is a Southeast Asia country close border to Vietnam, Laos, and Thailand. We have population around 16 million population. Actually, the confirmed case of COVID-19, we have 124 cases, but till now it recovers 120 already. So we still have two cases in treatment in hospital. During this COVID crisis situation, it is effect to economic Cambodia situation. It means that our GDP is maybe reduced around 3% as expected. So it is varies from other sectors. And COVID-19 is seem unclear, so we don't know when it will be ended. So our country is still meeting in the challenges. And then the challenge is in the manufacturing and garment sectors. Firstly, that we are assumed that firstly our garment sector will be lack of raw materials. That means import from China, mostly from China. But later on, the big problem is happened because of mostly of our garment sector is export to Europe and US. So after getting big impact, the COVID-19 expanding most in USA and Europe, that means the order is cut down. So our factory is closed. It affect to around 500,000 workers. That means lost their job. And secondly, our people also, that means return home from Thailand, also workers. So it makes around half million as well that return from Thailand. And regarding to this situation, our Cambodian, we meet our lockdown country situation only 5 days during our Khmer New Year. So the people can still travel, but only in our region, in our province and cities. But now they can travel around the country. Even though we are still traveling around the country, but mostly our business, let's say school, are still closed. Even private school and public school are still closing, and we don't know when it will be open. So most of students are still staying home or online learning. And others in the entertainment business, let's say KTV or hotel, are also still closed. So most of workers are still in lost the job. So they also lost their income as well. Regarding to these challenges in Cambodia, we we are in terms of marketer, we observe that all of most of company and others sectors now they are trying to invest in e-commerce business model. So they try to convert from traditional model to e-commerce business. Second, they try to invest customer service and loyalty program for all existing customer that they try to engage with their existing customers. And others, a recommendation is they should launch a new product every week if possible to make it happen, to make it to make things happen in online every week or every month. Fourthly, the distribution channel. So they need to expand the distribution channel, let's say home service. So now everyone, that means don't dare to travel to visit other crowded places. So when they need something, they want to order and delivery to for home delivery. Fifth, try to explore innovation and digital marketing. And lastly, but not least, as we are observing, all business now seem to be online, especially Facebook Live and Facebook promotions. Just this is from Cambodia, just we are stealing a lack of information on that. So this is just our sharing. So thank you for all.
So thank you very much, Thomas, for sharing with us the situation in Cambodia and also for your six very useful recommendations. Now, actually, we have gone past our time, and in the interest of time, let me summarize or try to summarize some of the main key points that we learned from the ASEAN Caucus. I need to be fair to our colleagues from the South Asia Caucus, who will be starting their program in about 10 to 15 minutes time, and especially to give an opportunity for our MIS colleagues who are organizing this event. They didn't sleep last night. I hope they have the time to eat as well. They've been putting in a lot of efforts. So from all our eight ASEAN member NMAs, National Marketing Associations, we have learned a lot. I think the driving lessons that we have learned is that in a way, it is challenging. COVID-19 has presented a lot of challenges, but within the challenges or within the crisis, there are still opportunities. So I think it is a very good time for us marketers to think about this, re-examine the purpose of our business, re-examine what we really want to do. For example, course marketing and so on. So re-examine, take the opportunity, re-examine our business. What is the purpose of our business? Re-examine the customers that we want to serve. As Kundan has also mentioned, customers' behavior have changed as well. So we need to really understand our customers, re-examine the customers' segments, re-examine our products, our services. What are we going to offer? How are we going to offer? So many speakers have talked about the e-commerce, digitalization, for example, contactless delivery. So this will be a good opportunity. Re-examine our competitors as well. What are they offering? What is it that can give us a competitive advantage? Re-examine, review our talent pool. And also one very important thing is building relationship. I will leave you with just this saying, an old adage: a friend in need is a friend indeed. So if there are some ways that we can help, that we can help our customers, that we can help our suppliers, they will remember us forever.